गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी कम्प्लीटेड अवर सेकेंड चैप्टर, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द थर्ड चैप्टर, दैट इज द मनी एंड द इन्फ्लेशन. माई सेल्फ शामित्सु, एल पी सवानी विद्याभवन, अडाजन, सूरत. टूडे नाउ इन द थर्ड चैप्टर अवर फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज द बैटर सिस्टम. इफ आई गिव अ शॉर्ट इंट्रोडक्शन रिगार्डिंग दैट, एज वी ऑल ह्यूमन वॉन्ट्स आर अनलिमिटेड. And as a persons that are that is us that cannot satisfy all wants by one own self. In the past time, students, human beings used to satisfy their wants by exchanging goods and services among themselves. Such a systems of exchange for satisfying their wants are called the barter systems in a simple term. If we go to the meaning of the barter system, as I have written over here, barter systems of exchange means goods and services are exchanged directly for other goods and services that are termed as the barter system. The exchange of goods are done on the basis of the goods itself. Second point, the economic based upon the barter exchange is called the barter economy. If it is a barter system exchange, then it is also termed as a barter economy, goods on the exchange of goods. Third point, money has no use in these systems, as there is no value of money determined over here in the barter systems. Goods are exchanged in terms of the goods itself, that's why the money has no use. Yes, student, if I give you the one example regarding such, is that the farmer cultivating the crops and few portions of it would exchange with the weaver, for the buying of the clothes, and then to cobbler for buying of the shoes. So in this way, goods started getting exchanged in a easiest way. Barter system now could not fulfill the extra increasing need for the exchange of the goods, as a limit. There are humans as such, there are unlimited wants of the human. So this increasing demands and needs cannot be fulfilled by the barter system. So then this barter systems becomes limited. Why? There are few more reasons for it. Because of the increasing the population, second one, the socio-economic development, there is a wide development nowadays, so this barter system exchange of goods on the basis of goods is now come to the limitation. Third, resulted in an increase and change in the demand. The demand also varies now and then. So this barter system came to an and or it comes to a limitation. The another reason, industrializations, urbanizations, division of the labor, specializations made the barter systems limited. Such systems, that is the barter systems, occur during the primitive phases that of the human civilization, in which their life was very simple and easiest, as men were self-sufficient. But the day by day, the progress of the civilization, division of the labors on a large scale production, now this barter systems came to an exist. So this is not effectible due to the increase in the population, wide labor divisions, and so there are many unlimited wants. So because of this, barter systems came to a limitation and end. So these are the introduction and meaning portion of our barter system. Students, I have written only 3 points, but I have explained you many such points regarding the meaning and the introduction of the barter system. So you can write such points in your paper also. Now the second one today we are going to do is the limitation of the barter system. This limitation of barter system is also asked in the board exam paper. So this is quite important and prepare it thoroughly. So in that limitation of barter system, The first one is the problem of mutual adjustment of wants. We can also say as the double coincidence of wants. What does it mean? Now, first question, this one is the double coincidence of want is an important factor of this barter system. It means that as and when while exchanging of a goods, a person must have specific wants of those goods which other persons offer in exchange. But in such times, it occurs that there is no guarantee that such double coincidence will always be present. If I give you an example of this double coincidence, it is such. If one person wants to exchange wheat for the cotton goods, now he will must find a person who possess the cotton good first, and he is in need of the wheat. This is known as the double coincidence of the want. But in nowadays, such double coincidence of wants may not exist due to the wide increasing populations and unlimited wants. So here the person wants in exchange wheat for the cotton, then he must find the person who is in need of the wheat. So this double coincidence of wants occurs in the, it brings out the limitation for the barter system and comes to an end. Now our second point is difficulty in the storing of value. You can also state it as a lack of the satisfactory means of the storing value. Here there is an increase in the problem of the storing value. The value here is termed as the exchange value. As we can say here that when any particular individual produces on a large scale through one own efforts. But the main problem here is he had to exchange this produce instantaneously for other goods and services. As it was otherwise difficult to store the surplus goods or store the exchange value of this goods. Here also one more example. If a farmer may exchange wheat for pair of shoes or clothes, but when the productivity rises, he produces more wheat, there arises a problem of strong surplus wheat now, as there is a huge amount of stock of the wheat. Now, if wheat can be stored for a long period of time, then at a future date, such stock of wheat can be exchanged for the new pair of shoes or clothes or rice. But here the main question arises, how to store the use and the surplus amount of wheat. Here happens that the value which is stored as a goods deteriorate day by day with the passaging of the time. Second, one has to bear the storage cost of the commodity. As we are storing a particular commodity, the cost of such goods we have to pay. Third, there was a difficulty in disposing of the stored commodity quickly if the owner needs to purchase anything else. If the owner wants anything else instead of such goods, then it will be a main problem to dispose of stored commodities. So here the many main more points are you can write students. In the lack of satisfactory means of the storing value, we can give the example of crops gets damaged, iron also gets rust. So problems are created by storing the goods. Therefore, the shortage of wealth, that is the value in terms of value of money, was not advisable. So we can write as a in this all the points difficulty in storing of the values. Now if we come to the third point, problem of the measurement of the value. Now the main problem over here is the measuring a particular value or a commodity, or we can say a goods. But due to the progress in the industrial sectors, there is a division of the particular labors and specializations. Now the main problem here is to measure the value of goods and services was emerging out. Earlier it was easier and simple exchanging the things that is goods in terms of goods, but now the it's create a problem as there are large number of goods become difficult to determine and maintain their exchange of value. So a problem arises when a person is having a large and a indivisible commodity which he wants to exchange for such a small quality of some other commodity. He is having a huge stock, that is large number of goods, but he wants to exchange. He can't exchange in terms of the small quantity of the goods. So it becomes a difficulty in measuring the value. If I give the example, if the 20 kg wheat is equal to the 40 kg of rice, so there is also a measuring problem. 10 meters of textile and 1 kg of ghee, it was difficult to exchange and measuring value. We can't measure out the 10 meter of the textile and the 1 kg of ghee. So their measuring values are different and the quantity quality is also matters over here. So in this system, the person who is in extreme needs of the goods will be at the loss. So he can't buy out the product when there is a wide difference of the goods and there will be a occurrence of the loss over here. So it was difficult to determine such measures and hence arose a need for the universally acceptable measuring tool. Here one more limitation, students, we can add that if future credit transactions is not possible smoothly in this barter system trading, as all the goods doesn't have indivisible form. So the problem of exchange can be rise and we can't do the any future credit transaction in this barter system. Now at the last, due to such limitation, that is the double coincidence of wants, lack of the satisfactory means of the storing values and the problem of measuring such value arises over here. Due to the industrialization inspired the need for the modern economy, so the money is the main mean of the exchange. Now this barter system cannot exist because of the unlimited wants. So there is a need for the money as a mean of exchanges arises. So students, today we are going to see only this much points. Now the next related topics will continue in the next sessions. So be prepared for this one. It is very easy and this one is important also. Limitation of barter system, as I told further also, this is already asked in the board exam papers for 3 marks. So be prepared. Thank you.